So I be holding my hand tonight. I'm feeling so cold to the touch. Do my eyes see the focus on some distant point? Why do I find it hard to talk too much?
Thank you.
have no shame, no shame, do what you think. I'm in the list of several tragedies of fame.
Thank you. Yeah, that was called
Beside Myself. We're going to play you one for the get out of the way. Sorry, I told you I was intolerant. Some idiot left the tambourine there, went all over it. Yes, it was me. This is a long piece that we're going to finish the first half with. It's one that, indeed, some of you may recognise, but probably not instantly. So we'll tease you a little bit at the beginning of it, and don't feel at all worried about calling out to say, we know what it is. But no bullshitting. We'll see you at the end, isn't it? It's an interval, and have a jolly good time having your cheese sandwich or your drinky or going for a tittle or whatever. And should you happen to be passing the merchandising stand, avert your gaze, because someone will try to relieve you of an enormous amount of money for a t-shirt, a program, or a funny hat. It's up to you. You've been warned. I have mine back in the dressing room, and I'm wearing it after the show. Come on, you can't be serious. That was a lucky guess, that's it.
Thank you.
Thomas. A me. A me. Yeah.
Thanks. Thank you very much. What a ridiculous ending to that song. Have you ever thought about that, Mark? But that's how we did it back in 1970 at the Isle of Wight Festival. Did you see that on television the other week? It was very, very, very funny. I enjoyed that. And I did. That was back when I had festival hair. In fact, probably the hair of the festival. It was amazing. I even washed it that night. I remember it distinctly. I don't know what happened to it. Must have left it on the bus. That was 1970. The next song is also from that era, and I think we last played this one in Carnegie Hall in New York when it was recorded for a live album. It was actually Martin who pointed this out to me, that I think around about 1970, we had a support group in America, a very nice bunch of boys who went on every night before we did, and they were called the Eagles, and they became quite famous, actually. But they used to watch us when we went on every night. We used to do this song every night, and Martin noticed, just a couple of years ago, he noticed that there was an uncanny similarity between the chord sequence in this song and a subsequent hit by the Eagles called Hotel California. So I have come to this conclusion. If the Eagles now decide to give me the royalties, or some of them, for that song that they clearly nicked from us, then I think I've come to this conclusion. I think I should take you all out to dinner. What do you say? And we'll go somewhere nice. But the bad news is, the Eagles are patently not that fucking stupid. No siree, Bob. They're hanging on to every penny. So we'll play our in threes version of the that chord sequence now. And it's called We Used to Know, if I can remember which pedal to press. I'll just turn this down, Martin. It's just teensy, 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 bitty too loud. Thank you. thanks as priest from the Divinity's album called In the Money, Lender's Temple, which was dedicated tonight to Martin's bank manager. He's going to catch up with you next week or two, I'm telling you. It's been calling my place, Sunday Faxes. He's going to take Julie's car back. You're in deep shit, boy. Back in 1970 or thereabouts, we were actually preparing for the making of an album for the following year. We used to go on stage every night and work out some of the songs that later appeared on that album, and this is one of those. It was another support group we had back then who were actually quite a lot of fun, weren't they? You're a big favourite of yours, Martin. I know that chap who played the tambourine, you know, well, the high voice, the John Anderson, that was his name. Yeah. Yes, group called Yes. Yeah. No, they were good back then. hey, listen, even we were good back then. We used to do this one anyway. It's a piece in which I used to get perhaps a little juvenile, used to get a little upset and angry and intense and kick my stick over and otherwise get a bit, you know. But with the passing of the years, I've matured and I'm going to sing this for you nicely tonight. It's a piece called My God.
Thank you.
know, with this plastic crucifix.
Endless, wide, silent.
Martin Burr. That was a piece from Martin's recently completed solo album, which we hope will be released very soon, and you may even be able to go and buy. It was a piece called Misère, French, I believe it means misery. An odd title for a song, but misery, misère. I miss my hair. I get it. Good. This one is for Mick Abrahams, our old chum from the early days, and he used to be a little chubby back then. That was back then, of course. Now he's a real fat bastard. But he's as ever a great guitar player and singer. And if you get a chance to see Mick, do go and see him and do buy his records because he's really good. And this is for him, and I wrote this about him because he kept farting overnight on a ferry ride, and I decided to get him back. And here it is. It's called I Don't Want to Be a Fat Man. Thank you.
was a middle distance runner. The translation wasn't clear. Could be a budding stately hero. International competition of the year. She was a good enough reason for a party. Well, you couldn't keep up on her 100 miles. While she ran a perfect circle, and she wore a perfect smile. Dusting off the mandolins and checking on the gear. Well, she was helping out at the backstage, stopping the parts and chilling a bit. Cares and legs went on forever. Light staring up at infinity. In Budapest, you can cut the heat, heal it back, but the wrong side of the night. Feel it blowing from the spot he fills. Feel like you were playing for your life. If not the money. Yeah. speak much English language. She didn't speak much anyway. She couldn't make a love, but she could make a good sandwich. And she poured sweet wine before we played.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you. That was a piece from 19, a long time ago. Not that long ago, actually. 80, help me, Martin, help me. 86, 87, something like that. Called Budapest. The next one is a piece from our new LP. It's the last one we're going to play from that album. And it's a sort of, it's a kind of a vegetarian song, really. One with, loaded with significant, deep, and meaningful ecological and environmental messages and stuff. Are any of you vegetarians? I mean, I try hard, I really do. Do you go for that stuff? I'm really working at it. Have you tried Linda McCartney's vegetarian sausages? Have you? From Sainsbury, have you tried those? They're shit, they're awesome. I've really worked at Linda's sausages, I really have. I just can't get to like them. The children keep buying them for me and I just keep spitting them out. I'd like to like them. So, we'll dedicate this song to Linda. Because no one else would. No, she's a great singer, really. She's good. Great wife and mother. Good snapper as well. And this is a piece called Wounded, Old and Treacherous. Not, of course, that we mean anything by that, but obviously.
Let me draw the jungle line.
cross yours if you don't cross mine. One makes love, I don't need no cross, but I'm wounded all the time.
Martin Barr, yes! See you later. Take care. Good night. Bye-bye.